Hello, this is Galen Martling, design team member with Unity Stamp Company. I have a pretty floral card today, and it is going to be in watercolor. I'm using Ranger Tim Holtz Distress Markers for watercolor on this card, and I'm also accenting with patterned paper. And so for the stamping, I'm using Unity Stamp Company's kit called March Beginnings with this beautiful flower and sentiment. And I'm also using Trick or Treat Paper Pack by Unity. I'm also die cutting using my favorite things. It is the flag die and the sentiment. It's called Hip Hip Hooray Dynamics. And so for the watercolor, I'm going to start by using Canson watercolor paper. And I pre-trimmed and pre-die cut that panel with a stamping on the smooth side of that panel for the stamping. And so now the way I'm doing this particular flower, I'm going to sketch in a color on the edges and creases and folds of each petal. And then I come in with a damp brush using water and blotting that excess water off onto the paper towel, a damp brush, and then I blend out where the outline area is, and I blend it into the petal to make a lighter shade. And I go over this a few times. It's not necessary to, do all of the flower all at once with the outlining. My preference is to use one petal at a time with the outlining and then go in with blending before you move on to the next petal. These distress markers could dry out before you get a chance to go in and blend them. And so that's just one of the keys and tips that I like to make sure I remember to do when I'm using the markers for watercolor. And so it really does present a soft look to watercolor using distress markers and distress inks, but it's something that I like to do. It's what I used to start my watercoloring in the very beginning. And I still go towards my distress markers every now and then. Some of them are dry, but you can also have a palette mat handy. I have an alt new palette mat to the side there. And you can, if your marker is too dry, you can just mark onto the palette mat and add some water and then place the color onto the stamp using a brush. And so sometimes I use one or the other methods. I have a few different markers that I initially started with, but I actually ended up using just the Mode Lawn green color and the Worn Lipstick pink color. With distress markers, you can get many shades using one marker. And so I used the darker shades on the folds and creases, and I blended it out with a paintbrush to get a lighter shade of that same marker. And I did the same with the leaves. I just touch areas of the darker and then blend it out with that brush. I'm going to also make a little ground area behind that flower plant just to make it look like it's in something. So instead of a vase, I sort of made a green, sort of a oval background grassy area on the bottom. And I just used the leftover, what was on my brush, to do that ground. So it is very helpful. Now, one other thing about these distress markers that I like is it has a fine tip end. It's got a brush tip on one side and a fine tip on the other. And I used the fine tip of the pink marker to color in the happy birthday sentiment. And so now I'm adding that same marker onto the palette mat, adding lots of water and a brush, and I'm splattering that same color right around the flower and the sentiment. I made a little paper trim mask for the flower and the sentiment just so that I can get the splatters on the outside of the flower, sort of a background look. And now I'm just assembling the card. I'm using the pattern paper. I'm going to go ahead and add foam tape to that flower panel and a polka dotted black trim on the top. And then the sentiment was die cut on on a gold foil paper. And that's it, really. It's so easy to do. I hope you give it a try. Thanks so much for watching. Take a moment to subscribe and have a great day.